Alright, let's go. Do you want this? Let's go to horror. Edgar Allan Poe says, "You barely make teenage girls whimper, Howie." Oh, Lovecraft? The other one's gotta be Lovecraft with the hairstyle. They call him Howie. Yep. "Only because they cannot fathom the dread I conjure, Eddie. You play on common cliches. Your penny dreadfuls lack true horror. At best, spooky pulp. Your best works aren't even written by you. Charlatan, fraud, undead trickster. If you feel that way, then why did you hide my work, Eddie? Again, I say, I do not have your book. You probably hid it because it was too scary for you. Gah! You're an infuriating man." I love it. We've got A through B, I through J, Q through R, and Poe and Lovecraft. Creepy bookshelf. Candles. These are one hell of an atmospheric fire hazard. This is the same for each one. This is one creepy looking bookshelf. I've never been up here before. Because of the broken elevator? Because it's scary up here. That's a cool horror section. They usually always make horror sections look like this. Alright, let's look at books and then talk to these guys. A through B. From Axes to Zero Oxygen, a murderer's primer. He's behind you! Animal Allotment. Stephen Duke's The Ankle Biters. Bemoaners from Beyond the Grave. Alibi Soup. The Butler Did It. Yeah, that's mystery stuff, not horror. It Kills! Just Quit. Jugular Wounds, an Illustrated Story. A Guide to Journaling Your Own Death. I Touched Its Face. Jobs You're Not Good Enough For. The Quirky Killings. The Rash That Wouldn't Clear. Quickly Hide. The Revenger. Quay 666. I don't know what that is, Quay. So most of it's Q, even though it's Q through R. So where's the rest? Is there more? It's just the exit. Let's talk to Poe. What's going on here? I didn't take his blasted book. It was that childish Blighton woman. Why don't you tell him that? He did. He will not listen to me. He's convinced I hid it so more people would borrow my books over his. Nonsense. I care not for his current zeitgeist. My works are vastly superior. Lovecraft? He's being such a child. I am clearly the greater horror writer. I tore apart the minds of a generation with my atheistic horror. With your atheistic rubbish. Right. I'll have you, mate. Come at me, you sickly twerp. You two, stop it, or I'll put you both in some kind of supernatural slammer. He started it. Oh, I never. It was you and your... I don't care who started it. I'm putting a stop to it. Wait right here. And not a peep. You two had best not be causing any trouble, you hear me? Alright, Blighton Woman. You know what though? Wait a second. I forgot who the card was of. Blighton Woman. Was Blighton the last name of the DIY ghost? I don't know where she's gone now. Raxa, you mentioned you were looking for stuff on the internet. How did you get past the internet blocks? Up to something naughty, Detective? Me? No, but I have this friend who needs to get past the library firewall. That's quite well protected. Surprisingly, I think Doris was worried somebody would hack in to steal her unpublished fanfiction. But I figure out the admin password so I can bypass the block. Want me to give it to you so you can use it too? Please. You received the item admin password. The password for Doris's internet block. So what is the password? Okay. Now Crowley should be able to browse to his heart's content. I'll let him know. Well, I want to know what the password actually is. Oh, I'm not going to use the computer, though? I wanted to use the computer. Okay, I've set it up so you should be able to browse whatever you want. No restrictions. Excellent! You may not want to stick around for this. Right, I'll leave you to your business, so... Shut the door on the way out. I think I'll leave him with some privacy. Did I sense? Yes, the beast's eyes are focused elsewhere. The air is clearer now. Well, clearer is maybe not the term I'd used. Come again, sir? So let me guess, the ghost is on Pornhub or something. Never mind, just don't go into that room if you can avoid it. As you suggest. Now, what's all this about a hidden room? I'll share what I can. There is a place hidden behind the horror section on the fourth floor. Behind the horror section. The source of the phantasmic pollution afflicting this building is within. How do I get in? One of the books in the L section is a lever. Pull it and fix this. Godspeed, man. Hear that, Dooley? Hear what? Oh yes, of course. We need to get to the fourth floor and open the secret room using one of the books in the L section. Wait. How do you know all this? Intuition? He's gone. Thanks for your help with that, Raxa. No problem. Happy to help a man of law break it. What'd you need to look up, anyway? Best not to talk about it. I just hope it doesn't show up in the library's usage bill. We need to get to the fourth floor, Dooley. There's a secret doorway behind the horror section, opened by one of the books in the L section. Alright. Are you going to keep wearing that toy as we run around this building talking to walls? Dooley, we discovered a case. The case of the missing marbles, maybe. Just want to look around before... Why is the window onto the roof locked? For health and safety reasons. Can I get the key? Afraid not. Why? For health and safety reasons. Just looking for other Dooley quotes. This is a longer chapter. Oh, there's Blighton. Excuse me, did you steal Lovecraft's book? So it wasn't the DIY, it was the children lady. He and that Poe fellow won't stop fighting over which one has the more frightful book. I took his book in the hopes it would stop their arguing. It seems to have just made it worse. Well, I shan't give it back until they stop their silly bickering. I just shan't. How am I meant to stop those two fighting? That is not my concern. You want this book? You stop their fight. There's gotta be a scarier book than theirs around here. Surely that would stop their bickering. A scarier book. Can you see the ghost too, kiddo? Ghosts? What nonsense are you filling his head with, Detective? Officer Dooley says that. I see them. They're my friends. Well, this one is. Some of them are less friendly. But I like them because they... Because before they came, the place was empty. Just me and Doris, and she's only interested in reading the mostest dreadfulest books ever written. Maybe she has scarier books. Everyone seems to be talking to the air but me. I always knew I was the sane one. Then maybe she has a scarier book to give. I'd like to borrow that book you're reading. You need a library card to borrow books. Can I sign up for one? No, I'm too busy reading my book to help. So's. Dooley, can I use your card? It still has fines on it. I'm gonna use the sticky card. I bet you wish you'd let me make a deal now, huh? If you need anything else, I'll be here. Unless I'm not. Okay. Here. Can I have that book now? Not with this sticky no-picture-having card, you can't. Aw, man. Thought for sure that would do it. Maybe the DIY lady can help me some more. Oh, that's right, she's gone. Alright, I think we're just gonna go then. Up to the hidden area. Push the L. The book Yeats mentioned is missing. I didn't know you were a fan of Lovecraft. Hmm? You're looking at the Lovecraft section. A bit too godless for my tastes. Oh, the Lovecraft section is full of gods. Just don't get me started. Oh, so that's the missing book. I wonder if the missing book is the one Blyton took. Blyton took it? Oh, L! Oh! He has the... okay. Alright, what am I supposed to be doing with the sticky library card? So the book that these guys are looking for is also the book to enter the secret room. So what am I doing with this card? What are we gonna do with this card? Oh, the dust. Can I use the sticky library card to move it? Wait a second. I said it was moved recently. So, what do I do with the dinosaur? Makes me think it was moved recently. That's a hint. So how do I move the dinosaur? It was moved recently. Sorry about that, guys. I don't know. I don't know what to do with this card. Okay, maybe I do want to use the photocopier then. Can I? I really don't want to put my face on here, but I really need a picture of myself. The things I do for this job. You received an item photocopy. Okay, good. Now we will add that to that. The picture I photocopied of my face. Bloop. This is going to be the least convincing fake ID I've seen in all my years as a cop. Fake library card. A badly photocopied picture of my face, poorly glued onto a library card that clearly belongs to somebody else. I'd say that this wouldn't work, but I've been around the block enough times to try it out. I wonder what he says about this now. No, one is enough. I don't need to experience that smell again. Here. I'd like to borrow that book you're reading. Oh. Well then, here you go, Paul. Paul? His name is... My name is Paul, like it says on the card. My card. Paul, Paul, Paul. You received a trashy novel. Did I look at this plant? Oh, yeah. Milo Stevenson's reverse vampire novel, Guylight. Even holding it makes me ill. Okay, so this is a scarier book. So I'm supposed to go up and show them a scarier novel. Is this my book? No, it is not. What is it? The most horrific novel ever written, and it's not written by either of you. Let me see that. Teenage girl, blah blah blah, reverse vampire, blah blah blah, love story. It sounds terrifying. Its mere existence gives me shivers. Do you agree it's more horrific than your works? Will you stop squabbling? Agreed? Agreed. Can you believe something so hideous exists? Can you believe it's so popular? Stoker must be turning in his grave. I hope the poor chap doesn't know. Well, they're gone now. Back to finding the book that opens this lever, I guess. I know exactly where it is. Okay, and they took the book, I guess. Surprised they could stand to do it. Children. I've gotten them to agree on the scariest book. Can I have that novel now? Good. I daren't see why you'd want this vile thing, but I did promise. Here. You received Lovecraft novel. Aw, you ruined this kid's, the kid's illusion, Detective. Eh. Yeah, that's right, because he doesn't see the, ghosts. You have your rotten book, now leave me alone. The indescribable rending things that rend indescribably. Sounds about right. Hey man. Even the worst Lovecraft title sounds better than that. I'm a Lovecraft fan. Yes, I am. I have a couple videos, actually, of me reading Lovecraft. Just search on my channel for Lovecraft. So now up to the horror to put the book in. Boop. Here goes nothing. That seemed to fit with a curious clicking noise. Right, we pull this end. Well, there's the hidden door Yates and Crowley were talking about. He has no idea what we're talking about. Creepy doorways are a recurring motif I'm not too fond of. Let me guess, staying here to cover me again? You got it in one, Detective. Try to avoid getting knocked out this time. I think I hate my job. Spooky doorway. I wonder why they didn't pick somewhere less suspicious to put their hidden, creepy room. As we wonder... What the? What is all this? Magicka, Aleister Crowley's guide to the popular wizard game. The Gnostic's guide to ghouls and ghosts. Rituals for modern rituals. These are all contraband occult books. This is quite the nasty treasure trove. What didn't I know about this stuff? You know, someone's right here. Ritual book? Okay, exposed wiring. Looks great. Skull. Books. Those loose wires seem to run to the roof. I knew we were going to have to get to the roof at some point. Ritual book? A copy of Ripley's Castered or Not. It seems to be open on the Summon Spirits page. Maybe if I close it, this whole mess will sort itself out? Ouch! Seems to be charged by this faulty wiring. I wonder where it goes. Alright, we'll look at some books. The Necronomicon. I saw Clopian Cookbook. Necronominom. Nominom. That is funny. 101 Ways to Get Ritual Stains Out of Your Carpets. A Brief History of Time Magic. The Art of Pentagram Drawing. A Guide for Syncing Your Coven with the Moon. And these are just, yeah. Baseball cap. A strange thing to see here. Normal library fare, this. I received a skull. Okay. A small and heavy skull with the engraving Killed in Taiwan. It's Mort! What's up, Mort? Hey, what's up, Chief? Crawl space. A small hole. I don't fit, but maybe I can drop something down to see where it lands. Alright, there's a vent with a draft in the kids' room. The children's room. Books room. Like a skull? I can drop a skull in there? Shelly? Okay. The periodic table of secret magic elements. The bumper catalog of magical components. This one is just squiggles. I can't make anything useful out. The definitive guide to demon identification. Lovin' your coven. I like that. Lovin' your coven. Occultism for nuns. Put skull on baseball cap. Put skull on ritual book. Alright, so we're gonna talk to Shelley. So, what are you doing here? Like the moth to a flame, I am drawn to the eldritch energies emitted from this book. Hmm? I like spooky books and electricity. I even lit candles to up the spook factor. Okay. You want a skull? Alright, so let's drop the skull in the crawl space. I hope this works. Thunk, 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 crash. Now, where to find that landed? Hopefully without having caused any damage. So, I'm not completely sure why we did that. Yes! Again! Again! More destruction! More chaos! Ha 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 ha! I think I'll just go see where that skull landed instead. Children. Librarian Doris says, what's all this noise? I can't hear myself read. So, kid, what do you know about the other side of this vent? I didn't mean to do it. Do what? I was lonely, so I went exploring. I found all these neat new books. But the one I read was scary, and I ran off. Then the ghosts arrived. But I liked them, because now I have friends. See? He meant no harm. Troublemaker, arrest him! Breaking and entering. Into your room of illegal books? Let's say both set of charges cancel each other out. Only if you get rid of the books. I mean, only if you get rid of the ghosts and find him somewhere else to go once in a while. He could join me in the Blood Wolves. What? Blood Wolves? The mayor stopped paying the dib tax? What? So we had to change from scouts. Dip, 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 tax. You okay with that, kid? Sure. That's great, but back to the task at hand. We need to stop energy flowing into the building and into that book. You'll need to get to the lightning conductor on the roof. Here, have the key. Dooley, we're going to the roof. But it's raining outside. I received a roof key. The key for the roof access. Access. You dropped a skull on me. Through you. You'll pay for this. I'll send goblins around to poke you in your sleep. I'll have a pixie steal your mail. I'll get brownies to expletive on your lawn. Whoa. Calm down, lady. Get rid of the storm and the ghosts and we can forget about the kids' escapades. Happy enough to become a blood wolf? I sure am, mister. I can't wait to do all kinds of scout blood wolf. All kinds of blood wolf things. I've already started reading about them. Skulking in bushes, wiretapping, reading alien binary. You'll fit right in. Everyone seems to be talking in the air. Yeah, same thing. Now that looks like the kind of place a bored kid would explore. Alas, poor Yurik. In hindsight, that was dangerous. Thankfully, nobody got hurt. You blighter! That could have killed me. Except that you're already dead. Police brutality, that's what this is. Alrighty then. To the roof. So she's not at reception anymore. Just gonna take a little look around. I don't know why. Still busy in there. I really hoped it wouldn't come to this. So, like, we use the key on the window? I'm just checking here really quick. Here we go. I suppose I've already ducked out of one room in this case. I knew I played that card too soon. You did, buddy. You did. Wiring. More of that wiring from the secret room, and it leads to the roof. This is why I end up with overdue fees. Every time I bring a book down, I end up on the roof in the rain. Who wouldn't avoid that? What? I get up to adventures when you're not around, you know. I don't just cease to be because Frankie McQueen's having a night in. But Darkside Detective. Pfft. It should be called the Occult Officer. I'm going to climb the ladder now. Probably for the best. Okay. Yeah, there's nothing really to do, so I am going to climb the ladder now. Do you need me to go all the way up there? Scared of heights? No. Yes. Oh my. Yep, we got stuff going on here. How come so much of our work is done at night and in the rain? Junction box. So what do I need to do? Back out so I can look at other stuff? No? Reset. Oh, I need to route stuff to me. I can't exit out. I wanted to look at mother stuff. Okay. Do I drag these or something? Oh. Oh, wait. Well, where does it need to go to? What am I doing? What am I doing with my life? All right, it's neither of these, and oh, I didn't realize I can move these. So wait. Do I need to have it go through this other one or just turn it off? Evidently not, because So, maybe we need to go through this one then. The only thing is I'm not sure why. But fine, we'll do it. Wait. Got it. Holy crap. Ouch! My hand! Look, Detective, the storm is dying out. Imagine that. You mean it would have happened anyway? I didn't have to solve the damn puzzle? Okay, we should be able to close the book now. Jesus! Now that the sky has cleared up, it's quite a nice night. That seems to have done it. Now to go close that book. Anything else to look at? Oh, the moon. What are you at? Looking up there behind the storm. Chuxy moon. Well, the storm is gone. So I don't know what you're talking about. Whatever your name is. I've no time to critique wiring. I need to get the book closed. I'm done with the roof. All that's left is to close that book. No time to chat. I need to close that book. I can't even look at anything else. The ghosties are going away. Bye, ghosties. Officer Dooley says, "Trunks fill, detective. Though I don't see why we had to take all these books." Dooley, they're contraband. Heavy contraband. We have an agreement then, Doris? You don't fine me for having the books. I don't sue the kid for entering the vault. I go back to business. Sans haunting. Can you sue a minor? You should also get that wiring fixed. Ugh, fine. Come on, Dooley, let's get back to the office. See what can't, Mr. Dooley. See you there, Devin. Case closed. Okay. Glad I finished that one. I hope no more puzzles like that, please. So stay tuned for next episode, guys, where we will be playing Disorient Express. Until then, thanks for watching, and always, seek adventure.